Hi Aquarius, this is Tracy from Northeast Tarot, and welcome to your December 2016 monthly tarot forecast. This is for Aquarius Sun, Aquarius Moon, and Aquarius Rising signs. So Aquarius, for this reading, I am using the Universal Tarot deck, along with the Magical Messages from Your Fairies, Oracle Cards by Doreen Virtue, and then also I'm going to be pulling you an additional Romance Angel card by Doreen Virtue. I do highly suggest, Aquarius, that you watch your sun, moon, and rising sign. If you do not know what your moon or rising signs are, I do have linked below in the description bar a website that can calculate that for you for free. And I am doing a Celtic cross spread. I always do a Celtic cross spread for all of my monthly tarot forecast. And of course, Aquarius, if you are interested in a private reading, please head over to my website. I do have it listed below in the description bar as well. And if you are looking for additional guidance aside from the weekly and monthly tarot forecast that I offer here, please head over to Facebook or Instagram, because I do actually draw and upload a daily oracle guidance card every single day to my Facebook and Instagram pages. All right, so the overall energy, Aquarius, for the month is the Four of Swords. Okay, so the Four of Swords, for some of you, it's a patient energy, so you're waiting. And then for others, this is you maybe spending some time alone. In the month of December, there could be some Aquarians that maybe you're spending a lot of time alone. For some of you, you're recovering from something. Maybe it's an illness, or you know, you could have just went through some difficulties. And this is you now recharging your batteries. This is you now healing and recovering from that. It's not a bad energy by any means. For some of you, could be just spending a lot of time alone. For some of you, could be going on vacation in the month of December. You could be taking a break from work. You could be taking a lot of time off in the month of December for some of you. Now, the energy right at the start of the month, and for some of you, because I'm filming this at the end of November, you could be experiencing this energy right at the end of November. We have the King of Cups crossed by the Nine of Swords. So, for some Aquarians, you could be dealing with a Scorpio, Cancer, or Pisces person, male or female, right at the start of the month. This could be a person that's on your mind. For some Aquarians, this could be a person that maybe with that Four of Swords you're waiting on. But I see some sort of anxiety or some sort of worry surrounding this person. Now, for other Aquarians, this is going to be your energy, no matter if you're male or female. You certainly could have water in your chart. But the King of Cups is, he's a man, he's a person who's very much in control of his emotions. So he's more of an emotional person, but on the surface, he's very calm, cool, and collected. So for some of you, there could be something that's bothering you, but you're playing it very cool on the surface. You know, also he's a very loving, caring, gentle person, someone who's very compassionate, someone who's highly, highly intuitive. But with the Nine of Swords as the crossing card, this can be, for some Aquarians, you very much in your mind, dealing with some anxiety, some worry. You could be losing sleep at night with the Nine of Swords. So take caution with that. For some of you, I think with the Four of Swords here, I think that you're either waiting on this King of Cups, or this is you emotionally attached to something. This could be something to do with a relationship. There's something that I feel like your heart is in it, and you're waiting on this. And that's why for some of you, you're dealing with some anxiety or some worry in regards to this. Because at the foundation, we have the Wheel of Fortune. So there was some sort of change for many of you that has taken place with the Wheel of Fortune at the foundation. This could be something happening, Aquarius, within your life that was meant to happen, that was destined to happen. So for some of you, this wheel could have turned, and this could be with matters of the heart. For some of you, this is definitely related to relationships. But we have, for some of you, I feel like this is the wheel starting to turn. So for some of you, it's almost like the Wheel of Fortune can be in reverse, which it's positive either way, but when it's reversed, it's just turning at a much slower pace. So just the fact that we have this energy present is very positive. This is a very blessed, fortunate energy. But I think that for some of you, it's just turning at a slower pace. Something has begun. This wheel has started to turn for some of you. And then for others, something could have happened that was very much meant to happen. So for some of you, maybe a cycle has ended, a new cycle has begun. Because I have the Nine of Pentacles in the recent past, and also that Four of Swords, here is the overall energy. For some of you, you could have went from being married or in a relationship to now you were single in the recent past with the Nine of Pentacles, because this is very much an independent single energy. Also, the Nine of Pentacles is very good financially. This is living a comfortable lifestyle, having things built up, having more than enough to splurge on yourself, but then also, you know, splurge on friends, family, whomever. This is definitely being in a really good place financially. Also, for some other Aquarians, this could have been a piece of property that was quite significant. You could have moved to a new home. Or there even could have been something to do with, you know, a job, something to do with assets in the recent past. For some of you, this could be what you're waiting on. But then for others, I definitely feel like this could have been you going from maybe being married or in a relationship to maybe taking a break. Even if you haven't completely broken up with someone, this could be certainly for some of you, a very small number of you, taking a break. You could have become single, and then for others, you could be taking a break. Now, crowning you, we have the Six of Swords. So mentally, you're ready to move forward. This is crowning you. So this is what you're thinking about. You're ready. For some of you, it could be moving to a new home. Absolutely. This could be physical movement. And then for others, this is you mentally moving forward. I feel like you know what it is that you want. You're ready for it. For some of you, this could be what you're waiting on. But you're moving forward. You're moving from stormy waters to much more calmer waters. Now, if you were in a relationship and you didn't break up, you could have maybe just dealt with some challenges. I do see for some of you that were, you know, in a relationship where it was a little rocky or dealing with some difficulties, I do see a lot of healing energy around you this month. So you definitely could be healing your relationship with your partner for some of you. And then for others, you know, that maybe you ended a relationship. This was you, maybe newly single in the recent past. I see potentially someone new coming in, or someone that you know, because around the second week coming up in the near future, I have the Knight of Cups. So for some of you, this could be someone that you know coming back. And then for others, this can be someone new coming in. There could be an offer of love that's coming in around the second week. They can absolutely be a Scorpio, Cancer, or Pisces, but they don't have to be. They don't have to be a water sign person. This can be an offer of love that's coming in around the second week, or just an offer that's coming in that's very significant. Now, for those of you that are not receiving an offer, this can, of course, be you actually extending an offer as well. So you could be extending an offer to someone, but this is also still forward movement. So mentally, you're ready to move forward. This is a little bit more of a slower paced forward movement. It's not as slow as the Knight of Pentacles, not at all. But this could be for some of you, this is you still moving forward, moving towards your happiness, your wishes. And then for others, this could certainly be an offer of love coming in. It very well could be from a water sign person. Now, for some of you, this could be a younger water sign person. And then for others, because we also have the King of Cups here, this could certainly be an older, established person that is maybe presenting you an offer. Now, in the position of your power, we have the Star. So this is beautiful. So for some of you, I absolutely see you moving towards your dreams, your wishes. For some of you, wish fulfillment, absolutely. But in the position of your power, this is beautiful. You're surrounded by that divine energy. You're on the right path. This is a nice confirmation that you have the Star here. You're on the right path. You're going in the right direction, Aquarius. And this is also for many of you, being in a really good place emotionally. I feel you healing. And then also I feel many of you just very, very optimistic at this time. So this is beautiful. Around the second, the third week, for some of you, what it is that you've been waiting on and what it is that was maybe causing you some anxiety is now coming through for you. For some of you, this is absolutely wish fulfillment. And then for others, this is a beautiful healing energy. As a matter of fact, you have a lot of healing energy in the spread, Aquarius. And then for others, this is, of course, that optimism, that very optimistic attitude here, very, very positive. Now, in the position of how other people around you are viewing you, I have judgment. So you have some very powerful major arcanas here. We have judgment. So for some Aquarians, in the position of how those around you are viewing you, for some of you, you're making a very important decision. You could be receiving a very important decision. For some of you, this could be something legal. And then for others, judgment can represent that awakening. So for some of you, you're hearing the call. You could be taking action because this is how other people around you are viewing you. So for some of you, you're taking action. You're hearing the call. You know exactly what it is that you have to do. And you're definitely, you know, for many of you, this is you receiving that, that divine guidance, that assistance. Maybe you're noticing signs, you're receiving messages. I feel like for many of you, you're very, very intuitive in the month of December. And I see many of you starting new beginnings or moving forward, moving towards starting something new. Judgment is, this is a healing energy as well. So for those of you that maybe you have someone from your past, this could be like an ex that's coming back around the second week. For some of you, this could be you giving them a second chance, of course. And then for others, this is you rising up from difficulties. This is you rising up from the ashes. Being reborn in a sense. A lot of healing energy here. And in your hopes and fears, Aquarius, we have the Three of Wands. So for some of you, this is hoping for your ships to come in. There could be something that you started, something that you're waiting on. Again, this wheel could be turning a little bit slower, but you know, it's happening. So for some of you, you're waiting on your ships to come in. And then for others, threes really represent growth and expansion. So for some of you, you're waiting on something to take root. You're waiting for that growth. You're waiting on that expansion. And you're leaving the month of December with the energy of strength. So this is what you are leaving the month with, this energy. And you're starting the new year with the energy of strength. So for some of you, you could be waiting, honestly, on something to take root with a Leo. This could be relationship related. This could be business related. But you could be waiting on a Leo. Or you could be starting something with a Leo. With a Three of Wands here, something taking root. This could absolutely be something taking root with a Leo. A Leo could be very significant for some of you. And then for others, you know, this is you maybe, yes, having to be patient. Having to go within and rely upon your inner strength. I do want to look at the next card. I want to pull an additional card for clarification for you guys. Let's see what else comes up. Okay, the Hierophant. So for some of you, this could be a relationship with a Leo. And you could be waiting, you could be waiting to get married to a Leo. For some of you, you could be waiting for that commitment, waiting to take things to the next level. The Hierophant is that more traditional relationship. Now, if this isn't a Leo, this could be with a Taurus, because the Hierophant represents the sign of Taurus. So for some of you, you know, either a Leo or a Taurus could be very significant. Also, the Hierophant can represent very important documents. This can be something legal. This could be something involving the government or the company that you work for. So yes, for some of you, you might have to be patient with maybe you're waiting on a raise or promotion or maybe documents, something from the government, something from the company that you work for. But the Hierophant is also faith. So this is you very much needing to keep the faith, okay? Which I feel like that's a a theme throughout the month for you. Very much remaining positive, remaining optimistic, keeping the faith, and knowing how strong you are. Now, for some of you with strength here, this could be you needing to take the bull by the horns or needing to take control of a situation, needing to go within and have that courage. For some of you, when it comes to maybe a situation dealing with the company that you work for or something legal or something to do with the government, but very much needing to keep the faith, needing to remain positive. I think it's going to be an amazing month for you, to be honest. Financially, I think it's going to be a wonderful month for you. With the Nine of Pentacles here, I feel like for many of you, you're in a good place financially. I see a lot of healing energy here. So for some of you, you could be healing from maybe a relationship that came to an end. If that's the case, you could very well be reconnecting with someone from your past around the second week. Or for some of you, this is someone new coming in. I definitely see a Leo, a Taurus, or even a water sign person being very significant this month for you, Aquarius. Emotionally, I think it's going to be a wonderful month for you. I just think that for many of you, this is a nice confirmation that you're on the right path. You're going in the direction that is going to lead you to great happiness here. So let me pull you an additional guidance card. All right. And I'm also going to be pulling you an additional Romance Angel card. So some additional guidance for Aquarius in regards to love and relationships for December 2016. All right, so I have a bunch of cards that flipped out, but only one flipped over. So that's the one that I want. All right, very interesting. So the additional guidance card that I have for you, Aquarius, is whom do you need to forgive? As you release old anger or resentment, you will find that your true wishes come true. So I do see some of you needing to heal, but also needing to forgive. So for some of you, this could be you needing to forgive yourself, absolutely. Maybe you need to forgive a water sign person. Maybe you need to forgive a Leo or a Taurus. But forgiveness is significant here. As you release old anger or resentment, you will find that your wishes come true. Now, in regards to love and relationships, this was very interesting. This was the only card that flipped over, so I feel like this is the most significant. And it's pay attention to red flags. The signs are cautioning you. Now, for some of you, I feel like this is the message. The signs are cautioning you, because I got that very strongly with these energies that you have here. So I feel like you're receiving messages from spirit, many of you. You need to see the signs. And then for a small number of you, yes, pay attention to the red flags. You do have this Knight of Cups character around the second week. So if this is an ex that's returning, maybe spirit is just simply cautioning you. You want to make sure that this person has maybe changed. So, you know, pay attention to the red flags. Pay attention to the signs. Okay. So Aquarius, I do hope that you found this reading helpful. And I do wish you a very Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Take care.